Since my childhood, I have been fascinated by technology. Remote-controlled cars, robots, and computers. I had them all. I remember coming after school and sitting on my PC for hours and hours, writing programs and making my own games. As every other kid in India, I took up non-medical in school. I studied H.C. Verma for 2 years. And then I got into IIT. In college, I loved making technology. Back in 2006, even before the Google Docs came out in India, my friends and I invented DDocs, a collaborative editing, coding, and painting tool. 4 years before the iPad came out, we invented one of India's first tablets. We took off-the-shelf components, like resistive touchscreens, and made a very rushed-looking product. Now I could play my favorite game, Pac-Man, using just my fingers. But as I was building all this, my GPA dropped massively. I felt stifled, but I never ever thought of dropping out. I finally graduated towards the bottom of my class. On the day of our convocation, we were made to stand in the order of our grades. My father later asked me, "Why were you standing so far end in the queue?" And I lied to him. I said I was standing in the order of my surname. So I left India in 2009, thinking I would never come back here again. Meanwhile, my invented technologies got deployed at Harvard Medical School and Stanford University, leading to some fantastic opportunities. On a vacation in Uttarakhand, while I was a bit high, out of nowhere, I got an interview call from MIT. I still don't exactly remember what I said, but I got in. The MIT Media Lab was a very different place. We had engineers, designers, artists, photographers working together to invent the future. Inspired by my work, my love for photography, I invented a 4D camera, a camera in which you can take any photo and refocus it later. I then went on to invent scaled reality, a transparent display through which we can augment the world around us. We can make objects bigger, smaller, modify their shape, form, or size using just our gestures. But while I was building all this, a few questions kept bothering me. Why wasn't it possible for us to build this future in India? Why wasn't it possible for us to create an environment where people from all walks of life can come together, collaborate, and solve real-world problems? At every chance we got, my colleagues and I at MIT came to India to conduct design innovation workshops. It's here we met a lot of talented kids like Vinali and Kaustubh. Some of them were from metro cities, but a lot of them were from small towns like Ambala and Nasik and Indore. Some were in college, some were less than 15 years of age, some worked in companies, some were dropouts. For the very first time, they were interacting with somebody from a different discipline. An engineer was talking to a designer to an artist to a technologist. We started innovating. Building tech such as 3D printed biomechanical prosthetics for amputees. Flexible and foldable displays, a future in which a piece of paper can act like your phone, your tablet, and your television. And fabric 3D printers. Now you never have to go and buy your clothes again. You can just download them and print them. And many more of such innovations. For us, it was not about grades, fancy degrees, labels, or working in big companies. For us, it was about creating an environment where there was no fear of failure. For us, it was about finding people and making them believe in their potential. This is exactly what I had cared for when I was in college. Seeing these talented individuals, I thought, why don't I come back to India and let me invent a global hardware product out of my own country. I set up my company Tesseract and started to look for my dream team. Some of the great folks that I met at the workshops joined me. Varun left his job, Gaurav his college, Shreya skipped school, and Varun his family to make this product. When we went out to seek funds for it, nobody would believe that a bunch of 25-year-olds who had not done a product before could actually make a technology out of India. We were on our own. To figure out manufacturing, we traveled all over the country. We talked to big industrial zones and small shops. We showed them our product. Some got it, some didn't. Some wanted more volumes, some more money. But nobody saw the bigger picture. We finally found two guys, Abhijat and Tohit, local manufacturers in Sakinaka, a small suburb in Mumbai. They had been working in the automotive sector for the last 10 years. When they saw our designs, they felt excited, and they agreed to do the manufacturing for us. The final thing in the product was packaging. And we found that in Asia's biggest slum, Dharavi. About 1 million people are working every year to create goods worth than $1 billion. I was completely fascinated by this ecosystem. And finally, beating all odds, we created the world's first 360, 3D, virtual reality camera. Every bit, every atom was carefully crafted out of India. When we went out to sell it, nobody believed this is done in India. People said this must be done in China. Some said we don't believe that an Indian company can make both hardware and software. But we did. Let me show you a live demo. We right now, for the first time at a TEDx event, are live streaming this talk in 360. Here you can see the audience, all of you. Yes? I can just swipe around and go to the stage. Now you can capture any piece of content, any piece of video, and when you revisit it again, it'll feel as if you've been teleported into that moment. This is the power of 360 and virtual reality. 6 years after India's independence, this team created India's first hardware product, India's first analog computer. And they built it by getting transistors and capacitors from ammunition factories in Calcutta and using scrap metal from debris left over after India's independence war. And this is my dream team that I found after a journey across different countries, but only to come back home and discover the potential of young India.